Hi. Welcome. I'm Aubrey. Welcome to an effervescent event production live stream workshop. I'll be your host today. I'm so glad you're here. This is a core strength and awareness workshop. So over the next little bit, what we're going to do is spend some time breaking down the anatomy of the core, but I'll give you guys just a couple minutes to get popped on and get streaming before we really, really dive in today. And I'd like to let you know that I have my wonderful husband and partner in crime next to the computer this morning. So as you're getting logged in, if you have any questions, please feel free to put them in the chat box today. Please utilize that because I want to make sure you understand the information that we're covering today, because it's going to help you. It's going to help you with your practice when we dive in. So this first half, it's going to be lecture. And the second half will just be a fun practice where you have an opportunity to truly embody what we're learning and what we're discussing today. So if you don't already have a yoga mat out, go ahead and grab your yoga mat and roll it out. When we get started with our physical practice later, you may want to have a blanket nearby, a yoga blanket. You may want to have a yoga brick or some books or something just to help you get the support that you need throughout our practice today. Also, feel free to have some water nearby. And I would highly suggest grabbing a pen and paper if you're not as familiar with anatomy, and it might help solidify what we're going to learn today. So let's get started. So first of all, what's the core? What is it? I mean, because that word is kind of in vogue, right? You hear people talking about having a strong core, and usually they're meaning their abdominal muscles. And usually, a lot of the times, it's about wanting that six-pack abs, and you're wanting the that strong core that you see on the front of magazines, fitness magazines, and so on. But the core is so much more than that. We have over 30 muscles from here to here. And so today we're going to break down some of the bigger major muscle groups within that area. So first of all, when you are thinking of the anatomy of the core, really, there's a couple different functions. It's not just about abs. For a second, just pause and close your eyes. Sit up real tall, feel your sit bones ground and lift your heart, and just take a couple deep breaths. Feel your belly rise and fall. Notice what's happening in your body as you take breaths. Where do you feel it? Where do you notice it? Now place one hand on your belly, or maybe two. Do you feel it moving? Now maybe place one on your low back, one on your low belly and on your low back simultaneously. Is there any movement in your back? Now move your hands from off your belly and your back and move them to your ribs and take a deep breath. Is there any movement there at all? Now what about on your heart? You take a deep breath. Is there any movement there at all? And I don't know about you, but I just felt a little bit of movement in each area, more in the belly, a little bit more in the ribs, and the least amount right here in the chest, but I still felt it here in the chest. So the point being of that is your core, the muscles of your core serve a couple different purposes. Mainly, many of us come to core work because we're wanting, maybe we have back pain, and our doctors told us in order to relieve our back pain, we need to strengthen our core to help our postural muscles be more effective. And that's one main reason. The muscles of the core help us stand up straight and tall. It helps us maintain that posture. It helps relieve, it helps alleviate pain within the body that we need to just stand up tall. It takes a lot of muscles to just stand up tall as humans. But as we go deeper and we go deeper and we go deeper, because the thing I love about studying the core is it's really metaphysical. So we have this superficial aspects of our being, which is what we look like from the outside, right? Having that six pack, standing up straight and tall. But as we go deeper into our being, within this central area of our body, we also, it also contains all of our guts, all of the majority of our organs, all through here. So they also serve as a purpose to hold our guts in and keep everything inside. You know, our organs are what keep our body moving and keep our body functioning. And so we got to keep them in there. We have to protect that part of our body, yeah? But that's not the only thing the core does. We go deeper, deeper, deeper. We also, we have our, you know, our muscular systems that we're protecting through our, the engagement of our muscles. But then we go deeper into our bones, you know, it's protecting all of our bones and our organs. But then we go even deeper to our energy body or our pranic field, say what we would call that in yoga. That's our breath and how we move our body through our respiratory system, because the respiratory system is more subtle than the circulatory or the muscular system. So we go even more subtle into the breath and how we use that. So you just noticed how as you put your muscle, your hands on all the different parts of your body, how you felt those muscles moving. So not only as you strengthen the muscles of your core, are you able to stand up more straight and tall and be more effective in the movement of this physical creature that is this meat suit that you're wearing, but it also helps you be more effective with the quality of your breath, which is really important, because 95% of all illnesses or diseases stem from stress, and a direct way to help alleviate stress is through deep breathing. Because of all of the science behind it. It soothes the central nervous system on so many ways. And if you're really interested in learning more about that, we'll probably have an intro to pranayama workshop coming up here after a while, here in the future. And pranayama is just breathing exercises. So we'll go deep into that later. This could be a full day if we wanted to do all the aspects of breathing and the muscles all in one day. So what we're going to do actually is, now we understand all of that, let's break down, what do those muscles look like and how do they work and how do they work all together and how do they function? So easiest way for me to help here is I'm going to strip down a little bit, because sometimes we're all different creatures of learning. And if you learn better through visualization, I'll help break it down on my body. Don't mind me as I take off a few layers. So we're going to be going through all the muscles and their function and how to activate them, okay? And we're going to go from the outside in and then from the inside out. So starting from the outside in, of just where they are and what they do. So our most superficial layer is our rectus abdominis. The rectus abdominis is this top layer that you see right here in front. It's what makes the, if I were to really engage it, some of those six-pack muscles, they're individual little muscles along the front half of the body. They connect up at the sternum. They also connect down in the pelvic area. And the main function of the rectus abdominis, this top layer here, is simply to bend you forward. That's the main function of the rectus abdominis. Now, flip over to the back. And we have right here in the middle of our back, right here, we have the rhomboids that squeeze our shoulders together, which is a part of the core. But then we also have the latissimus dorsi, which is this big, beautiful triangle muscle that starts right up at the back of the shoulders and comes all the way down your back like a big upside down triangle. And these are the muscles that work in conjunction to not only keep your body upright and tall, but also serves to help extend your spine, pull your shoulders back, and extend your spine backwards. You also have your erector spinae, which runs right up and down the spine, what helps in that motion as well. But everything bending you back are the rhomboids right here at the top, and the latissimus dorsi that attaches and squeezes down. So those back muscles, and then the rectus abdominis pull us forward. All right, so out, working our way in, we have the external obliques. So the external obliques start up in the ribs and go all the way down into the pelvic area as well. So they start out and they come in. So imagine if you were putting your hands in your pockets. That's where they go. And actually, so when they're from your pelvis area up to your ribs, they are your external obliques. But as they go up into your ribs, and then they attach in the midline of your ribs right here all the way into the back. And when they come up here, then they're actually called your serratus anterior. So they come up in to the back of the ribs and the intercostal muscles. So your external intercostals are the ones right here in the front. External intercostals that come all the way down then into your obliques, and then you have your serratus interior. So it's the same thing, right? It's the same thing. They go up into your ribs and they help your body flex. Now, you think your obliques are all about, you know, you got the twisting. So when you do your external obliques, it pulls one shoulder to the opposite. You know what else they do? Put your hands on your ribs again. Take a big inhale and then exhale. Did you feel that in your ribs? How your ribs pulled down? Now put your hands right on your low belly, but on the outside. Take a big inhale and exhale. Did you feel a little bit of a pull right down from the base of your hip? Feel that again. Take a big inhale and exhale. So in that exhale, you had the muscles of your obliques come from down base in your hips and come all the way up into your ribs. And that helps with your exhale, the release of that breath. It pulls it out. So then we have the opposing. We have the internal obliques. And the internal obliques, they are a synergistic muscle, so that means they work together in an equal and opposite direction as your external obliques. So if your external obliques come here and go down, your internal obliques actually cross. So your internal obliques more run right along here, parallel, and they go down. And your internal obliques, actually, they were on the inside, go here and here. So it's like if you're giving yourself a hug. It's kind of sweet. Your internal obliques give yourself a hug and go down. And those pull the same shoulder down to the same side. They also help your body expand when you take a deep breath, and then your external obliques contract when you take an exhale. All right, cool thing here. We were just talking about on the outside of the ribs, right? You have your internal and external obliques that go into your intercostal muscles that are a part of the ribs. But then you have your diaphragm. And your diaphragm is like an umbrella muscle. And your diaphragm lives right down here underneath your ribs. So your intercostals are on top of your ribs and your diaphragm is underneath. So it's like this big umbrella. And how it works is it flattens. So when you inhale, it pushes the rib cage out. Take a big breath. And it flattens and it draws down. So as your diaphragm flattens and draws down, what it does is it just creates more space inside for your lungs to take a big inhale. Because technically, how your lungs work is your lungs aren't drawing air into them. You put your body into a different shape. And when you put your body into a different shape, based on your body's relationship to the earth and to gravity, your body will need to use different muscles in order to create space internally for there to be a vacuum for your body to draw the oxygen in. So the more space you can create internally inside your body, the more ability you have to take a deep breath. So really, the practice of yoga and putting your postures together is really just that practice in itself right there. Is how can you put your body into a different shape and maintain that shape and still breathe? So how do you have to draw your awareness into different areas in the body to create more space internally in that area for you to be able to draw more oxygen, more life force, more vitality into your body? So just take a deep breath and feel the diaphragm do its work. Consciously down to the belly. And usually when we take a diaphragmatic breath, they call it like a belly breath because you intentionally pull your belly out, because pulling your belly out makes the diaphragm drop down and out. Good. Okay, so last layer of muscle we're getting into is the transverse abdominis. And the transverse abdominis is my favorite muscle to talk about because I really truly feel like it's one of the ones that get jumped over so much in the fitness world because it's not the star of the show because you can't see it. It's the most internal one. It's your deepest layer of your core, of your muscles in your core. So imagine everything down deep underneath and imagine a girdle or guys won't relate to this, but a corset. So think of like Victorian age where the really tight layer around a female that would tight everything to make her waistline look really small and to help her stand up nice and tall. But the internal corset, your internal girdle, its main function is to hold your guts in. This job is to hold your guts in. So it actually doesn't go across your body at all. It is connected by fascia. So fascia is, it's if you were to skin a chicken and you were to pull back the layer of skin, the fascia is that white, foamy, fleshy stuff, squishy stuff in between the meat and the skin. So there's a connective layer of fascia right over your guts, and then your transverse abdominis then connects to the fascia and then pulls all the way around and attaches to your ribs and all the way deep into your rectus spinae around to your back. So it goes around your body. So this, what you see right here of your rectus abdominis, like there's no transverse abdominis behind it. It is fascia. So So your muscles only pull, they can't push. Okay, so since they attach in the back half of your body and come around, they're gonna pull it flat. They pull it flat. So how do we make it pull it flat? Well, it's funny. You're gonna bring your awareness to your belly, but that's not really what's working. So just feel this for a second. Pull your belly button in. Lift your heart. And now squeeze your pelvic floor like you're stopping the flow of urination. Did you feel all of that? I'm going to do that again. Okay, release all of those engagements that I just said. Because first of all, the transverse abdominis also goes down into your pelvis as well. All of these muscles go down into your pelvis, wrap and attach in different areas, and then also attach to the top of your sternum. So your key cues in order to activate any of these muscles are going to be squeeze the pelvic floor. And for your transverse abdominis specifically, because of what it does inside, is pull your belly button into your spine. Now see what would happen if you can imagine pulling it up and under your rib cage. And now lift your heart and relax your shoulders. Did you feel that tightening and engaging? Put your hands on your belly to feel it, maybe on your back. Let's do that one more time. Release all of your engagements. One last time. So engage your pelvic floor. Pull your belly button into your spine, up and under your rib cage. Lift your heart, relax your shoulders. Do you feel more engaged? Do you feel stronger and taller? Yeah? Good. So here's the thing though. If you're engaged in these muscles and you're having your belly button pulled in, up and under your rib cage, how do you breathe? Because you can't breathe diaphragmatically, right? Because your diaphragm, the belly goes up and down. Where do you breathe? Imagine, can you breathe into your obliques? Into your serratus interior? Those back muscles? The ribs? Can you find a greater expansion there? Just take some deep breaths and feel. So sitting up tall, pelvic floor engaged, belly in, belly button pulled up and in, heart lifted. And breathe without moving your belly too much. Now still engage, keep those engagements. Now move your hands to your ribs and see if you can move your hands. Crazy, huh? Crazy, huh? How you can keep your core stable, but draw your awareness to a different part of your body in order to activate it. So let's break down, activate each one of those muscles one at a time, moving on our way up, and then we're gonna start our practice, okay? And we'll put, maybe take just well, here we go. So go ahead and lie all the way down. Lay all the way down on your back. So as you lay down on your back, bend your knees, place your feet flat on the floor. And one tip of engaging these muscles and your transverse abdominis specifically is when you're laying on your back to take your tailbone and tilt it under, because that's gonna help activate all of those engagements in the front. Because if that low back is swayed, there's going to be a little bit of slack in the muscles in the front. So just giving that slight bit of the tailbone tilt to alleviate any space in between your low back and the mat is going to help you activate those muscles. The important thing though is with that tailbone tilt is that it's not overdone. Okay, it's gentle, it's just a small tilt, but it's not a gripping and it's not a squeezing necessarily, it's just a slight tilt, okay? So then once you get your tailbone down to the floor, engage your pelvic floor and walk your shoulder blades down your back. Engage your pelvic floor, low back down, walk your shoulder blades down your back. Now imagine squeezing your pelvic floor like you're stopping the flow of urination. pull your belly button into your spine and now up and under your rib cage, as if you just put on the tightest pair of pants that you possibly own. And imagine just holding that and pausing and noticing where you have to breathe as you do that. You breathing into your obliques, your serratus interior, your back muscles, your intercostal muscles, the muscles between the ribs, in order to keep that low belly pulled in. Good. Now, there's going to be times whenever you're working out when you bring your hands behind your head. Yeah? So did you notice what just happened when you brought your hands behind your head? Did you notice how when you did that, your rib cage wanted to pop open naturally? You were laying on the floor like this, right? But then you brought your hands behind your head and what happened? Boom, that rib cage popped out of alignment. So what we have to do consciously in that point is to activate these muscles. So from here, we take a deep breath and we imagine that there is maybe you can sew or knit these muscles together. Deep breath and close it, okay? Because when you bring your hands behind your head, your obliques and all of your intercostals want to naturally open just from the shoulder opening. So you have to make a conscious effort to then use your breath to close the gap and engage the muscles. So then anytime you're doing a crunch, this is where my mind goes. So I inhale when I'm on the floor, and I'm breathing into my back body, these muscles back here, because they have room to expand because my elbows open, yeah? So I breathe into my back body. Imagine that. So breathe into your back body. And then as you exhale and you crunch forward, you draw the muscles of your obliques in, engage them, and close. So, and you engage through the rectus abdominis. So now inhale, breathe back into your serratus interior or your oblique muscles in the back of your body. Open them up and then exhale. Use the exhale muscles to contract. Release the breath out of your body. Did you feel that? Yeah. Okay. So the same thing is going to happen when we're doing any sort of twisting motion. Okay, so just imagine real quick, sit up nice and tall, lower engages, upper lifts, relax your shoulders, nice and tall, and now just begin to look over one shoulder, and now inhale, come back to straight and tall in the middle, and exhale, twist and see if you can pull from your obliques to make it happen. And inhale, come back to center. Okay, friends, we're about ready to do a practice. Are you ready to take everything that we've just learned and put it all together for a practice? I hope so. I hope so, because that's about what's about to gonna happen right now. So let me get some music on for us. And let's get ready to get rolling. And before I push play, does anybody have any questions that they would like to have addressed that wasn't crystal clear before we get going? Let's just take a second and give you a second to type in any questions. You know what? We're going to take just a 2-minute pause and break to let you guys type in any questions that you have. I'm going to run to the bathroom real quick. You run to the bathroom too. Empty your bladder, because I'll tell you this. If you have anything in your bladder right now, it's going to be hard to do your movements and do them correctly. So if you have any questions, type them into the chat. I'm going to run to the potty. You run to the potty too. Get your mat set up and we'll get started. Hi, we're back. I hope you got set up. Jacob, did any questions come in?
Nope.
Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and get started. Go ahead and grab your mat and grab a blanket if you have one. If you don't have one, that's okay. But we're going to start with just lying down on our belly to breathe, to feel your muscles, to feel the muscles working. So go ahead and lay all the way down on your belly. I like to take a blanket and wrap it around, make it a horseshoe to give a little cushion for my breasts and under my armpits. This is not required, it just feels good. And then you can stack your hands on top of each other and let your forehead come down to your hands for comfort. If your forehead doesn't feel good, just resting on the floor. And then explore what feels better, whether you want your big toes to be together with your heels falling apart, or whether you want to open up your feet nice and wide with the toes out and the heels in. So take a moment and figure out which one of those feels better to you and get settled into a beginning place. So go ahead and take a big inhale. Exhale, make a sound. Again, big inhale. Exhale, make a sound. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale, make a sound. And now just allow yourself to ground. Allow yourself to arrive. And now start to notice where you are in your breath and in your body, without trying to change anything. And now, with every inhale, feel your low back expand. And with every exhale, feel your low back just relax. So consciously starting to draw breath into the diaphragm. So you're using your back, the awareness in your back, to lift, to start to activate the muscles in the diaphragm. And now you draw your awareness to the belly and feel the inhale, lift the back, and press the belly into the floor simultaneously. And then on the exhale, I just allow it to relax. So inhale, you consciously activate the diaphragm from the front and the back to feel the expansion. And then exhale, they relax. As you're breathing into the low belly and the low back now, let's invite the obliques and the intercostals into the party. So as you inhale, draw awareness into the back and the belly and see if you can feel the ribs expand from side to side. And then exhaling, imagining if you feel a slight hugging from within to release the breath. So inhaling, low belly, low back, side body, all expands. And then exhaling, low belly, low back, side body. Engage just slightly, feeling like that slight hugging from within. On your next exhale, see if you can activate the exhale through engagement of the pelvic floor, the muscles that you squeeze to release the flow of urination. So on the inhale, the pelvic floor relaxes as if you are allowing your urine to flow. You breathe into your belly, your back, and your side body, all the way to your heart, all the way to your heart. And then exhale, engage from your pelvic floor, release from your low belly, your low back, and your side body. So as you breathe, notice how as you relax your pelvic floor, there creates more space inside all the way through into your ribs. And on the exhale, as you activate that pelvic floor and you feel that hugging from within, you feel your transverse abdominis and your external obliques working together to help release your breath out of your body. Full activation of all of your internal muscles working together right now. Inhaling, you feel the expansion. Internal obliques work on the inhale, helping create the expansion in the ribs. And on the exhale, you feel the transverse abdominis from the pelvic floor all the way to the heart and the external obliques through the ribs, engaging and pulling the breath, releasing the breath out of the body. And wherever you are, just feel all of those muscles and take three more full, conscious, deep breaths, activating and noticing how all of those muscles in your core work together. All right, friends, it's time to start moving our bodies today. So, from the lying down position on your belly, if you have any props or anything, just kind of come up and press back into child's pose and just release your props out of your way. And as you press back into child's pose, you bring your weight back into your heels, your glutes back into your heels, and you extend your arms all the way down to your mat, letting your forehead come down to your mat and just breathing here. And notice how when all of a sudden you change positions, the breath, your shape changes. The body, your body changes, the shape changes. So now you can draw breath into different areas. Notice how when you're in child's pose, how you can really open the back body. And how helpful it is to exhale and really engage the front body on the exhale. And now from this position, bring both hands into prayer. So whether your hands are down on the floor with your fingertips pointing down to the wall, or whether your fingertips point up to the sky like a church steeple, pause here and set your intention for class. We all showed up this morning for our own reasons, so remember right here, right now, why you're here. Two more deep breaths. One more. Good, now extend your arms. And walk your arms all the way to the right. And push through the left hip. And breathe. And as you're pushing through the left hip, imagine breathing into your left anterior, so your serratus interior, so the back of the left shoulder, the back of the left rib. Imagine breathing into that with every inhale. And on the exhale, imagine squeezing that right oblique just to help you engage and release the breath a little bit more. So take one more full deep breath here into the back of the left rib. and then walk your hands all the way to the left, pressing through the right hip. So as you walk your hands to the left, pressing through the right hip, breathe into the back of the right shoulder with every inhale. So breathing into your serratus anterior, the back of the shoulder. And on the exhale, squeeze through your left oblique to help release the breath out of your body, activating your muscles. So let's take two more deep breaths like this. Breathing into the serratus anterior in the back of the shoulder, exhaling through the right, left oblique. One more time. Good, now come back to center and come up onto all fours. Hands directly underneath the shoulders, knees directly underneath the hips. Now it's really important in your yoga practice, anytime when you bring your hands underneath your shoulders, make sure your pointer finger is pointing to the top of your mat, not your middle finger. Why? For our latissimus dorsi and activation of our intercostal muscles. Because what happens is, just notice, when you take your hands, sit back on your heels for a second or come up onto your knees, whatever feels better. Externally rotate your hands and draw your awareness to right here, to this part of your body, deep into to your shoulder and to your latissimus dorsi where they attach. Turn your hand out. Did you feel that attachment happen? Did you feel that? Do that one more time. Good. So from this position with your hands, rotate your hands out. Feel that connection deep in your body. And now don't change anything in your arms and just bring your pointer fingers back up towards the sky. Do you feel that still engagement through here? That's what you want to feel in your arms anytime you do anything in a plank or all fours position. Yeah? Okay. So you know, just bring your arms out there and flop them out there. You engage them. You pull them down in. Okay? So let's find that position. All fours, hands directly underneath the shoulders, knees directly underneath the hips. Pointer fingers pointed to the top of your mat. Let's give us a little more volume because this is a good song. All right, so feel the engagement in your arms, knees directly underneath your hips. Now just sway the back leg up and round the spine. Look at your belly button. And as you do this, we're just waking up the spine. We're stretching all the muscles. So as you come into cat, you pull your belly button in and really squeeze your belly button in and stretch all of your back muscles. And as you inhale, sway your back and open up your heart. Really feel your back muscles all engage as you just let your belly muscles hang. So you're having them all work in conjunction with each other. Right here at the beginning, breathing and opening. And then if you really want to take it a step further, draw your awareness into your spine and see if you can move each vertebrae one at a time. And it really starts to draw your awareness deeper into your body. Good. Let's take one more round. Now find all fours. Hands directly underneath the shoulders, knees directly underneath the hips. Pull your belly button into your spine. Point the crown of your head towards the front of the room and your tailbone to the back of the room. So what did we just do, friends? We just activated your transverse abdominis as we did that, okay? So your internal girdle, that it's gonna hold you all in. You wanna maintain that right there as we do this position. So tuck your tailbone, pull that belly in so you're working your rectus abdominis too. So don't let the belly hang. You wanna pull it in right here. Good, now extend your right arm out in front of you and then press your left leg behind you. Good. So you're working right here your erector spinae, which are all the muscles along your spine, holding it in, protecting it in. Good. One more breath and then release. Other side. So make sure you have that strong posture. Tailbone's pointed to the back, crown's pointed forward. Pull your belly in. Feel those engagements in your arm. Extend your left arm forward and then press your right leg back and breathe. And hold and feel how long you can make your body from fingertip to heel. Good. Take one more deep breath. And now release. Now we're just going to flow from side to side, okay? So inhale, right arm, left leg. And release. Exhale. And then inhale, left arm, right leg. And right leg, left arm. And then exhale. And to continue flowing from back and forth, from side to side, for just a moment. And notice as you inhale, find the length. And on the exhale, transition. And just start to notice how much awareness you have to bring into your transverse abdominis, that deep belly, pelvic floor extension, in order to not wibble wobble. Try to avoid the wibble wobbles in transition. That's what you're practicing right now. That deep stability from your transverse abdominis, deep inside. Good. Find your balance from right to left. Good. And then slowly release, press back into child's pose. We're gonna add on to that. We're gonna do one more thing with that. So take one more deep breath here. So that was all about the transverse abdominis. Now we're gonna bring the rectus abdominis to the party. So come back up, same thing you just did. So same thing you just did, nice and long. Extend one arm out in front of you and then the other leg back. So take a big inhale and then exhale, pull your elbow in to find your knee all the way in. So now you're working your rectus abdominis and now you extend and you find your transverse abdominis. And then exhale, pull it in. You're using your rectus abdominis to crunch you forward. And then inhale out one more time. Exhale, pull it in. Engage. Inhale, lengthen, and then release. Let's do the other side. So first, set up your transverse abdominis. Make sure you're strong. Tailbone's tucked under, belly in. Head is pointed right in front of you. Feel those engagements in your arms. Good, left arm extends, right leg presses back. Inhale, and then exhale. Pull your elbow in to find your knee. Pull your belly button in. Inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, pull it in. So every inhale, feel that strong transverse abdominis in the center. And then exhale, feel your rectus abdominis work in conjunction with your transverse abdominis to bend you forward and to pull everything up and in. Let's do one more. And exhale, pull it in. Good. Inhale, lengthen. And release. Great, press back into child's pose. Take a couple deep breaths here. Enjoy this. Yes. So now let's break down our modified flow, our modified sun salutation. I'm gonna be teaching it modified today because honestly, I think that we get more benefit out of strengthening in our arms and our core when we practice on our knees. If we're not ready to practice on our toes and we practice on our toes too early and it's sloppy, okay? So I'm going to practice on my knees today. But if you want to take this to your toes later in class, I'm not going to, don't let me stop you from advancing your practice, okay? So, from plank position, or from all fours position, all fours, walk your hands a hand front forward and then scoop your tailbone under. Tuck your toes. This is a modified plank, strong plank, core's engaged, good. So as we lower ourselves all the way down to the ground, our elbows pull into our ribs as we come down to the floor. What I want to avoid seeing y'all do today is doing this. I call it the belly roll, where you go, oh, flop down. You're not using your core at all there, okay? So you're using your transverse abdominis to keep you in nice and tight. Excuse me. I flopped out of here. So you're using your transverse abdominis to keep you in nice and tight and held in all the way down. And your transverse abdominis has to hold your belly in as you come down. And from here, right here, guys, remember your rectus, remember your rhomboids right here that squeeze together? So from here, we come down to our modified plank. Now squeeze your rhomboids together. Drop your hips. Oh, you're in baby cobra without even having to do anything else. You just use your core. Press back into child's pose. Let's just do that two more times. So inhale forward, kneeling plank. Feel it nice and strong. Lower down to chaturanga. So bring your elbows to a 90-degree angle. And now just squeeze your rhomboids together and drop your hips and tuck your toes. Baby cobra, you're right there in position. Last time, press back into child's pose. Inhale forward into kneeling plank. Try to stop at 90 degrees if you can. Come down and then squeeze your shoulder blades together. Drop your hips. Cobra. Now, if you want to press up higher into cobra today, that's your own prerogative, or even coming up into up dog. But what I really want you to avoid is this. Straight arm. You know, notice how there's no curvature. The point of cobra pose or up dog is to stretch the belly and to squeeze your kidneys behind you, okay? To activate your kidneys and to stretch your belly. So, come back into child's pose. Let's do one last thing. Let's find our peak of our cobra. So inhale, kneeling plank, core is engaged. Exhale, come down to 90 degrees. Squeeze your back muscles. Drop your hips. Open up to cobra, wherever you want to be today. Squeeze your rhomboids together. Press back into child's pose. Now tuck your toes and lift up and back into downward facing dog. Really start to bicycle your heels. Press one heel and down and then the other. Breathing, letting the head and neck relax, pulling the belly button in. Good. Now let's ground through our downward facing dog. We have starfish hands, shoulder width apart. Our head and neck is hanging like fresh fruit ready to be picked. Our belly button's pulled into our spine, up and under our rib cage. Our tailbone's lifted high. Our inner thighs are pulled back to the back wall as we do our best to sink through our heels. So let's just breathe here for a second and let's notice our breathing muscles in downward facing dog. So notice as you breathe into your down dog, and you can breathe deep into your belly here. You can breathe deep into your belly, but you can also breathe deep into all the muscles of your back. And now notice on your exhale, can you really pull your belly button up and under your rib cage on the exhale? Notice what happens. And then inhale, take a deep breath and see where you can expand. And exhale, really pull your belly button up and under your rib cage, because what that's going to do is it's squeezing your guts right there, pulling your guts up against gravity, helping them detox. Do one more breath. And then squeeze your belly button up and under your rib cage. And then walk your feet all the way towards your hands. Walk your feet all the way to your hands. Let your head and neck relax. Nod your head yes. Shake your head no. Letting go of anything you're holding on to in your head, neck, and shoulders. Good. And then slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders up to the ears and down the spine. Let's take a couple more big shoulder rolls like that. Shoulders up to the ears and down the spine. One more. Excellent. I need a sip of water. Get one if you need it. Get water anytime you need it during our practice. All right, so let's start by warming up the body just a little bit. So open up your feet nice and wide, toes out, heels in. The interesting thing about the core is that the core muscles actually start in the feet, believe it or not. I know that sounds weird, but your pelvic floor is actually attached to your feet. So just standing with the way you are right now, lift your toes. Lift your toes. Did you feel when you lifted your toes how it engaged into your legs and that comes all the way up into your pelvis? Do you feel that? Now relax your toes. Now imagine, can you feel what it would feel like to lift your arches? Oh, did you feel that? Lifting your arches pulls all the way up into your inner thighs, which comes all the way up into your core muscles. Tucking your tailbone under, lifting your heart, rolling your shoulders back. Good, now inhale, reach for the sky. And exhale, let's just sit down into a goddess pose. Good. So in goddess pose, the tailbone's tucked under, the shoulders are open,
and the elbows are just squeezed down because you're engaging your latissimus dorsi here to pull those elbows down and in. Squeeze your hips open, tuck your tailbone under. Nice and engagement. Let's just inhale, reach for the sky. Exhale, pull down into goddess pose. That's it. Inhale up. Exhale, pull down into goddess pose. Good, just warming up our body, feeling those muscles working. Now really avoid the urge when you come up and down to let your booty pop out. Keep that tailbone tucked under. It's gonna take a little bit more effort. Good, one more. Now come down into goddess pose and pause and hold for me. And open up your arms into sun god. So palms are facing up, tailbones tucked under, belly's pulled in, heart lifted. Now inhale, reach both hands to the sky. Now exhale, reach underneath your right thigh and tap your fingertips to underneath each other, underneath your right thigh. And then inhale, reach your hands all the way back up to the sky again. And then exhale, tap your fingertips together underneath your left thigh. And as you do this, now just flow with your breath. And put your awareness into your muscles working. So inhale, we're lengthening, creating space in all of the muscles. And now exhale, we're using our transverse abdominis and our obliques right here to engage. Our external obliques help release the breath, but our internal obliques pull us in this direction. Good. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Good. Inhaling up. It's one of my favorite songs. Let's have some fun. Pull it down. So really feel all I'm working right here. Let's do one more on each side. It goes a little something like this. Other way. Good, now inhale up. And release. We'll go out your arms, we'll go out your legs. We're gonna do one more thing in that position, okay? And I want you to be ready. Working your obliques and your transverse abdominis again. So inhale all the way up. Exhale, sit down into moon god. So moon god is the same thing as sun goddess, but the palms are facing forward. So instead of facing palms up, you're just facing forward. So elbows deep into your ribs, tailbone tucked under, heart lifted. Good. Now from here, just bring your right elbow to your right hip, and then the other side. Doesn't that feel real funky, y'all? And just go from side to side. So what you're working right now is your transverse abdominis to keep your belly in nice and tight. And you're working your internal obliques and your latissimus dorsi together to move you from side to side. Your internal obliques and your latissimus dorsi are dancing right now. And if you want to add more, you can add a reach. So now not only are you contracting one side of your body and getting your internal obliques and your latissimus dorsi activated, but you're stretching your external obliques and your intercostal muscles and your serratus interior all at the same time. You got a lot going on here. Good. Let's find our balance from right to left. Let's come down into it. Let's inhale all the way up to the sky. And let's just stretch for a second. So wiggle your hands over to your right thigh. And just breathe here and open up the side body. But because this is such a good flow, or song, let's flow. So let's flow to the other side. So one breath, one movement, just flow. Because it feels good. Because I like this song so much, maybe you can add a body roll too or something like that too. Just have fun. If you want to take it deeper, you can. If you want to bring your hands to the floor, you can. But you don't have to, okay? Just getting a good stretch. So from wherever you are, let's just come to the right and let's hold. So maybe your hands are up on your thigh. Maybe your hands are down on the floor. Maybe you go deeper into your heel. However you want to go here, okay? So just breathe and find a stretch that feels good to you. Just take two more deep breaths. And then switch sides. So whether your hands, weights in your hands, on the floor, whether your hands are on your thigh, you can have your opposite foot grounded, or you can have your heel popped up and get a little bit of an inner thigh groin stretch simultaneously. Good. So let's take two more deep breaths. Excellent. Now come back to center. Let your head and neck relax and get one last deep stretch here. Get a nice wide straddle stretch. Grab your ankles and try to pull your head through. Pull your belly button in. Take one more deep breath here. Now bring your hands to the mat and heel toe, heel toe, heel toe, heel toe, heel toe your feet more into an aligned position. Let your head and neck relax. And then slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Inhale, reach your arms to the sky. Exhale. Come all the way down. Good. All right. So we are going to start moving through some sun salutations. But before we do, we're going to break down mountain pose, because mountain pose uses all of your muscles in your core. And if you start to practice mountain pose every day in your life while you're washing dishes, folding your laundry, or whatever, you are going to not have to spend as much time working on your core. Okay, so just by bringing more awareness into your core on a daily basis. So let's find mountain pose. Your feet are hip distance apart. Lift your toes. Feel a balance between all the four corners of your feet. Feel that engagement. Now relax your toes down to the mat. And pause and just for a second. Feel your pinky toe. Feel your middle toe. Feel your big toe all pressed down into the mat. Feel your arches lift. Feel your kneecaps lift into your hips. Feel your tailbone point down. And feel your glutes slightly engage to help you stand up even taller. Pull it in. Engage through your pelvic floor like you're stopping the flow of urination. Lift your heart. So you got your transverse abdominis connected. Shoulders up to your ears and down your spine. Feel link through the back of your neck like a soldier at attention. Do you feel your strong core right there? And just notice how strong that feels. Notice how challenging it is just to hold this. We're gonna take some deep breaths here, just standing strong in mountain pose, okay, ready? So inhale, reach your arms up to the sky. And just exhale, pull down through your heart. And really use your muscles. Inhale, reach your arms from the sky, but don't lose anything in your core. Exhale, pull down through your center. And squeeze those all the way down. Good. One more time, inhaling all the way up. And exhaling, squeezing all the way down. I'm not quite sure what happened to our music. Sorry, friends. Oh, there it came back. So now let's add on. So inhale, reach for the sky. Exhale, pull all the way down, but now forward fold, all the way down. Forward fold, come all the way down to the floor. So now, remember how we were talking about, you gotta put your body in a different position, you manipulate your body in a different position, and gravity and how to breathe. So when you're in a forward fold, how do you breathe deep and use those muscles consciously? Well, you breathe into all the muscles in your back. Can you breathe into your serratus interior? And then exhale, pull your belly button in to help you fold deeper. And then you get a deeper forward fold. Did you notice how that happened? So now inhale, breathe into your back body muscles. And exhale, pull your belly button in tighter, help you fold even more. Last time, inhale, breathe into your back body muscles. Pull your belly button up and in, squeeze out even more, good. Now inhale, come halfway up into monkey pose, lengthen that spine. No rounding in the spine. So to engage this and to feel this, pose, you really gotta pull your belly button in. And so you're holding through your transverse abdominis. And so now you're having to breathe into your rib cage again. So inhaling, you find the breath through your obliques. Exhale, you pull your belly button in. Moving slow, one more deep breath. Exhale, fold all the way down, release it all. Good, now plant your hands, step back into a plank position. Nice and long and strong. Now just for a second, everybody bring your knees to the mat. I want you to feel something for just a moment. So, point your fingers pointed to the front of the room, tailbone scooped under, belly's in, really feel that engagement through your intercostals, right through your shoulders, through those muscles right there. Now from here, tuck your toes, lift your knees. Now, if you can you draw your big toes an inch closer to you without moving anything else and without
tucking your body. So just like move your big toes an inch closer and then really press back through your heels. Did you feel that? Some of the weight just moved out of your core and into your legs, and that's really helpful. So just breathe, feel this here. Draw your awareness to your tailbone. On the inhale, follow awareness up to your crown. Exhale back down to your tailbone. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, drop your knees. Pause, inhale again. Now exhale to 45 degrees, elbows in, chaturanga. Inhale, squeeze your back muscles together, drop your hips for cobra. Good, and breathe here, exhale, hold. So inhale, breathe into the front half of your body. Exhale, squeeze the back half of your body to maintain the pose. Inhale, breathe into the front half of your body. Exhale, squeeze your back body to maintain the pose. One more time. Exhale, release all the way down. Big inhale, push up and back. Exhale, back to child's pose, and then tuck into downward facing dog. And breathe here. Rotate your groin to the back of the room. Take a deep breath. Exhale completely. And then look forward, step forward with your right foot. Bring your right foot all the way next to your right hand. Drop your left knee down to the mat. Engage through your pelvic floor, and then inhale, reach your arms to the sky. And breathe here, relax your shoulders. Relax your shoulders. Actually, if you want to, if you need to, you can bring your hands to your thigh if you want to. That's always an option. You can bring your right hand to the outside of your right thigh and then lift your left arm. So in this position now, we're breathing underneath our left oblique. We're breathing underneath our left lung. And then we're exhaling, leaning back just a little bit, pulling our belly button in, making more space on the front half of our body with the inhale. Exhaling, pulling back. One more deep breath. And exhale, releasing all the way down. Good. Step back into downward facing dog. Take a couple deep breaths here. One more. And on the exhale, look forward, draw the knee towards the chest, step forward, bring the left foot down next to the left hand. Drop the right knee down to the mat. Walk your hands up to your right, up to your left thigh. Point your tailbone down to the mat. Squeeze your belly in. Lift your heart. Now you can choose to hold here. If you want to reach your right arm up to the sky, that's always a choice. If you want to do both, you can always do both. Just breathe and feel the front half of your body expand. And then exhale, release all the way down. Step back into downward facing dog. Good, take one more deep breath here. Exhale completely. And look forward. Hop, step or walk forward, all the way forward, forward. All the way into your forward fold. Come all the way forward. Now in forward fold, make sure you can have two fists in between your feet so your feet are in alignment with your hips. On your next inhale, stand all the way up to the sky. Exhale to your heart center. Good. Now from here, big inhale. Exhale, sit down into a chair. But this isn't like butt out, okay? This is like you're sitting in a bar stool, so your tailbone is tucked under, your belly is in, your heart's lifted. So you're still in that same core structure, yeah, here? So feel your legs working as you're maintaining your core. Inhale, reach for the sky. Exhale, fold all the way down. Half lift long spine, lengthen your spine. Draw your awareness into all those engagements we just broke down. Exhale, forward fold as we flow. Ground through your hands. Step back with your right foot. Now it's your choice, right knee up or down, reach for the sky. Inhale, exhale, hold and sink into it. Inhale. And now exhale, come all the way down. Same thing on the other side. Step back into downward facing dog. Good. Look forward, step forward with your left foot. Bring your left foot down to your left foot next to your left hand. Your right knee's up or down, this time your choice. Inhale, reach for the sky. And then just hold here for a breath. Inhale and exhale. One more time. And exhale all the way down. Good, step back into downward facing dog. Look forward, let all the air out on the exhale. And now either step forward or hop forward. forward fold all the way down. Last sun salutation, friends. But now go ahead and bend your knees right here. Engage your pelvic floor, strong core, and now reach for the sky to find chair pose. And sit into your chair. Good. One more deep breath here. And now inhale, stand all the way up. Reach back, look back. Exhale, fold all the way down. Half lift, long spine. Exhale, fold. Plant the hands. Step back into plank position. Nice and strong, let's hold here. Draw your awareness to your crown. Inhale, exhale, press back to your tail. Feel your engagements. Feel nice and strong. Back where your shoulders attach to your latissimus dorsi. Feel that. Pull your belly button in. One more breath. Good, now bring your heels down. Bring your elbows in to 90 degrees. And now squeeze your back muscles behind you and drop your hips. Find your cobra pose. Good. And now exhale, press back into child's pose. Tuck your toes, go right into downward facing dog. Excellent. So now we're gonna go ahead and move through a warrior series here. So look forward, step forward with your right foot, ground through your left heel, and then cartwheel yourself all the way open. I'm gonna go opposite as you. So make sure your right foot is pointed towards the top of your mat, your left heel is back, your arms are reaching towards each angle of your mat. And now as you do this, though, square your shoulders to the long edge of your mat. Feel your feet and all the corners of your feet engage into the floor. So now draw your awareness right up into your core muscles. Tailbone's tucked down, belly's in, heart lifted, arms are extended. Good. So your transverse abdominis is what's doing the work right now. But now we're gonna stretch some of your side body. So here we go, we're gonna flip our front palm up and inhale into reverse and breathe here. So we're working and engaging side body as we're breathing into the other side. One more deep breath. Now extended angle, bring your forearm down, your opposite arm up and over. Good. So now where do we breathe? We breathe in the open side of the body. And we use the other side for the exhale. And if you want to go deeper, you can. You don't have to. Good. One more deep breath. Excellent. Come all the way back up into triangle. Now we're going to, or into warrior. Now we're going to find triangle. So straighten the front leg. You're going to really work your transverse abdominis now. Reach, 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 reach over. And now here comes your obliques. Drop one hand down and the other arm up. So now your obliques and your transverse abdominis are really working hard together to maintain this position, because you're not hanging out in this hand. You're using your strong core to maintain it. Now, bonus move, get a good stretch to the side body, and to breathe a little bit more, reach your fingertips to the front of the room. One more deep breath. Good. Reach your hand back up to the sky, bring it towards your hip, drop it down to the floor. Good. Step back into plank position. On your knees or on your toes, take a big inhale. Exhale, chaturanga, elbows squeeze. Squeeze the back muscles together to open up the front half of your body. And then exhale back into downward facing dog. Good. So now we're gonna do the other side, okay? So look forward, step forward with the left foot and cartwheel all the way open. Face the other way. So cartwheel all the way up into your warrior two. So your left toe's pointing towards the top of your mat. Your right heel's pointing back towards the back of your mat. Extend your arms, relax your shoulders. Good, so you feel your transverse abdominis engage you. Yeah, nice. So flip your front palm up and move into your reverse. So you can breathe through the side of your body and engage through the other half. Opening up your shoulder, relaxing it down. Good, one more deep breath here. And on the exhale, find extended angle. So forearm down, opposite arm up and over. So now you're breathing through this side of the body. Where is it open? If you want to start to melt down deeper, you can. Don't lose the posture. Don't lose your posture, find it. Good, now coming up, into triangle pose. Coming up into triangle pose. Good. Extend, 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 extend as far as you can go. Feeling strong right through your center. Drop one hand down, the other hand up, and open up through the side body. And breathe. So now you're breathing into the extension and contracting through the opposite side. And if you want more, reach your top arm up and over to really spiral the shoulder open. Take one more deep breath here. Then move your hand back up to the sky, back towards your hip, and then back towards the floor. Good. Step back into child's pose. And we're going to start to move down to the floor so you can start to feel those deeper engagements, okay? So let's take one more deep breath here. And if you want to, bring your hands back together for prayer pose and come back to that intention from the beginning of class. Or if it feels good, maybe you can extend those arms out in front of you and flip the palms up. And imagine what it would feel like to have your prayers answered. Imagine what it would feel like to have your intentions realized, and breathe here. Imagine yourself getting stronger from the inside out. Hallelujah. Imagine not having to work so hard to show up in your power. Hallelujah. Take one more deep breath. Good. And then come all the way up. And back to all fours. So we're moving into side plank and kneeling half moon poses. So from kneeling side plank, engage your hands just like we did before. Feel those deep shoulder engagements. And extend your front leg. And with the hand closest to me, lift it up towards the sky. And really lift through your waistline. Really lift through it. So you're breathing through the side body. And now, only if you want to, extend both legs. So now, right now, your stability is coming from your transverse abdominis inside, but also from your latissimus dorsi where it attaches to the shoulder. So where do you breathe? Well, you can breathe into the belly here, but it's a little hard. I breathe into my top rib. Then use my external obliques to really pull it in. One more deep breath here. Good, now from here, if you have your bottom leg lifted, bring your knee back down to the mat. And see if you can bring your knee closer in line with your hip, lifting up to the sky. Now, nice strong core, lift your leg. Oh, now did you see you have to use different muscles now to get the leg to lift? Oh, you feel how your hip is attached to your obliques? Did you feel that? Now, without moving your top hand, draw your shoulder towards your hip and feel. Oh, hello! Latissimus dorsi just connected to all of your intercostal muscles, all the way down into your obliques, all the way down into your hips. Really lift and breathe and feel that extension. Two more deep breaths. One more. Good. Slowly release. We'll stretch it out in just a little bit. Don't you worry, okay? So you can either come to the top of your mat. I'm going to flip around so we can still see each other nice, and so I can still look at you. So to do the other side, now back to all fours, we extend the opposite leg. And then we open up into our kneeling side plank pose. So from this position, really feel the engagement in your shoulder, the back of your shoulder, where all of those muscles attach. Good. Ground through the top of your foot and breathe and really lift the waistline here. Now choose to hold here or if you want to extend that bottom arm and really lift through that waistline, because that's what you're doing here is you're strengthening your obliques, you're strengthening your core. Breathe. Breathe.
feet into your top rib, and exhale, use your obliques to squeeze it back up and in. Two more deep breaths. One more. Now bring your bottom leg down, bring it down, and lift up. Good. Now when you're ready, lift your top leg. Now draw your top shoulder towards your top hip and feel the engagement through the side body. Feel all of those muscles attach. Feel all of those muscles connect. Feeling connection from the pelvic floor to the sternum, all the way through the side body. Good. Two more deep breaths. Really squeeze and lift. One more. And then slowly release. Good. Press back into child's pose. One more deep breath here. And then come all the way back. All the way down to your belly. All the way down to your belly. Bring your forehead down to the mat. Bring the tips of your toes down to the mat. Find cactus arms with your hands and your elbows. Point your tailbone down or press your pubic bone down to the mat. Pull your belly button in. So right now we're finding our transverse abdominis for stability. So as you feel ready, lift your heart, lift your head, lift your arms, lift your hands, and squeeze your back muscles together. Good. And really squeeze and feel all of those engagements, your latissimus dorsi, your rhomboids, your erector spinae, all the way to your transverse abdominis, all working together. We're going to do five of those. Ready? So inhale down. Inhale down. Exhale up. So notice on the inhale down, I'm going to breathe into the front of my body. And on the exhale, I squeeze my back. Inhale, breathe into the front of my body. Exhale, squeeze the breath out through the back. Two more. One more. Come all the way up and hold. And hold for four, three, two. Child's pose, release. Good. You'll start to find, as you move through your practice, continue to rest and continue to stretch, but you'll start to notice as you move through your practice that the more awareness you put on feeling the muscles that are supposed to be controlling your action and putting your awareness into the breath that's working with them, the less effort you're going to have to put forth to find the same results in your movement practices, in your workouts, in your somatic movement and therapy. So take one more full and complete deep breath here. And then slowly find yourself in a seated position. Working your way into a seated position. Let's extend the right leg out in front of you. And then draw the left leg in and go ahead and bring it across the body. So now we're going to be working all of your muscles in a twist, okay? All of your core muscles in a twist. So your foot is about in alignment with your knee. Inhale, sit up tall, feeling both sit bones on your mat. Exhale, bring your left hand behind you to your low back. So you have that nice, strong tripod. Inhale, sit up tall, lengthen through your spine. Now exhale, twist in your low belly and your low back. So feel your external obliques twist you. Inhale, lift up through your transverse abdominis, lift up through your heart.
exhale, twist in your middle back, your middle belly, but do it through the external obliques and through your serratus interior. So feel your ribs pull you back down. Do you feel that? So now inhale, lift up through your transverse abdominis to find more space. Lift up through your heart. And now exhale into your upper shoulders through the exhale in your shoulders. So feel the exhale in your shoulders, and also feel the exhale deep into your hips. Ooh, the end of the Tootsie Roll, twisting it nice and deep. Now inhale, lift up as high as you can, transverse abdominis. Exhale, see how far you can look with your head and your eyeballs, but ring it out through your ribs and your low hip, the front of your hip. Good. And let's just take one last deep breath here. And slowly unwind. Could you twist deeper than normal when you did that? I always can. Draw your knees into your chest to release. Release your back muscles. And now let's do the same thing on the other side. So let's extend the left leg out and draw the knee up and over. Foot's grounded next to the knee. Inhale, sit up nice and tall, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, bring your right hand behind you for support and still pressing out through your front leg. Good. And now inhale, nice and tall, find your transverse abdominis from your pubic bone to your heart. And now exhale into your ribs and the front half of your hip for your low belly twist. Now inhale, lengthen through your spine. Draw your awareness into your mid-back to twist, but can you do it through the exhalation and engagement of your obliques? Good. Inhale, lift up through your spine. Transverse abdominis. Now your external and internal obliques. Exhale, twist. Your interior, serratus interior. Inhale, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, twist in your upper back and shoulders through your obliques. One more deep breath. Let your head and neck follow. Pull that belly button in to its fullest. One more full deep breath here. And exhale completely. And now take your time to slowly unwind back to center. Good. Draw both knees into your chest to give yourself a hug just to release your back. Draw your knee in. One more deep breath. Good. Bring your knees together, or your feet together and your knees apart, and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle onto your sit bones. Sit up nice and tall. Lengthen through your spine. And then exhale, start to guide your heart forward. Inhale, find length. And exhale, melt. Again, where can you find more space in your back body? So exhale, draw your belly button in with every exhale to create more space in the back half of you. One more. And come all the way out. Bring your right leg in and your left leg out. Let's stretch our obliques and our side body after we did all that contraction. So sit up nice and tall. And then flip your right palm up and slowly allow it to slide down the inside edge of your leg. And as you do that, reach your left hand up to the sky. Pat yourself on the back with your left hand and point your elbow up to the sky. Now it's really important for your elbow to point up to the sky, not the front of the room, okay? Up to the sky. And then slowly just start to explore how far down you can go. But the elbow needs to point to the sky, not the front of the room. So if the fingertips go past the front foot, you can flip the palm up and grab your foot and then extend all the way down. But if that's not there, that's okay. Just stay right up here, or even up here. One more breath. One more. I feel this all the way from where my obliques attach at my hip, all the way down through my shoulder, all the way to my fingertips. Good, and then come come up to the other side. Bring the opposite leg out to the side. Sit up nice and tall. Wiggle onto those sit bones. Pull your shoulders back into their pockets so you always have those engagements. Flip your front palm up and then start to reach forward. Big inhale, reach your right hand to the sky. Pat yourself on the back, elbow up. And then just slowly start to slide down. Again, maybe your elbow just barely points to the sky, and maybe you stay up nice and tall and you still feel a stretch. Or if you want to go down further, you go down as deep as your body wants to go. One more deep breath. Good. Come all the way up. Give yourself a big hug. So we've done a lot of work for our transverse abdominis today. We've done a lot of work for our obliques. We've done a lot of work for our latissimus dorsi and our rectus spinae. There's one muscle we really haven't targeted today, and that's been the rectus abdominis. So we're going to end with that muscle. So go ahead and roll all the way down to your back. Roll all the way down to your back. And once you get all the way down to your back, go ahead and bend your knees. Give them a big hug for just a second. Okay, so now we're going to just break down a basic crunch, friends. We're just ending with that, okay? So make sure you do it with proper form from now moving forward. So knees bent, feet flat on the floor. Find your transverse abdominis by bringing your low back down to the mat. Engage your pelvic floor. Feel your heart lift so your shoulders walk down your spine. Your hands come behind your back. So when your hands come behind your back, feel your rib cage engage in the front. So close, so intentionally close the front half of your body here. Close, feel that engagement. Good. So now breathe into the back of your shoulders on the inhale. And even in the front of your shoulders, breathe into your chest. And on the exhale, lift your heart, lift your head, lift your shoulder blades, but your head comes up to the sky. Your low back presses down to the mat. And then inhale back down. So you maintain that transverse abdominis engagement, your low back press down. So you're literally now just isolating your rectus abdominis. So just the ones that bend you forward, and that's it. Doing them nice and slow. We're going to do four more. You're almost there. Inhale down. Exhale up. One more. Come all the way up and hold for four, three, two, and release down. Good. Knees bent, still feet flat on the floor. Let's stretch out that belly now. Go ahead and lift your hips all the way up to the sky by pressing into your heels and let your back stretch, or let your belly stretch. Maybe you hold here, or maybe you walk your shoulder blades underneath. Maybe you hold here. Maybe you bring your hands to your low back. So you're just exploring what feels good to get a stretch through the front half of your body because you just did so much work. So now choose to hold here for about another 3 to 4 more breaths, or if you'd like to go up for wheel pose, that's always an option. So hands are by your ears as you inhale all the way up into your wheel. If that's where your body decides to go today, you don't have to, but if that's where your body wants, take one more deep breath and then slowly come all the way down. Last pose right here. Let's end with a spinal twist. So bring your knees into your chest to release your back. Now from this position, go ahead and extend your right leg. Draw your left knee into your chest. Pause to inhale. And now on the exhale, draw your knee across your body. And then reach your left hand in the opposite direction. So notice when you're here, you have to breathe now in different places. In a twist, you got to breathe into your ribs and then exhale into your belly. Good. One more. Bring your head to neutral. Come back to center. Draw both knees into your chest. Give yourself a big hug. And then release and do the other side. So extend your left leg. Draw your right knee across the body. And then reach your right arm in the opposite direction. And look in the opposite direction. Breathing into your ribs. And then exhaling into your belly button. Take one more deep breath. Come back to center. Give your knees a big hug. And we're going to move now into our final relaxation just to soak up all the benefits of our practice today. So take a moment and just really get yourself comfortable. Do what you need to do. So if this were my practice and I weren't going to sit up and lead you through the guided meditation, I would possibly start the way we did at the beginning, lying on my belly, or maybe I would lay all the way down on my back and put this blanket potentially underneath my neck, or maybe put the blanket underneath my knees, laying on the back, or even put some bricks or some pillows or some cushions underneath my knees, because putting something a little bit under your thighs when you lay down helps the low back relax even more. So just take a second and find that position for you. And once you start to find that position, take a big inhale and release a sound. Again, take a big inhale and release a sound. One more time. And if you have any last fidgets or wiggles, wiggle them out or fidget them out right now. And then see if you can try to find a place of stillness and rest, and to practice stillness and rest for just the next few moments together. Allow your breath to become effortless. You've spent so much time during this practice paying attention to how you were breathing, so let go of worrying how you were breathing and just notice that you are indeed breathing. Now draw your awareness to the space in between the crown of your head and your brain. Do you have anything that would like to soften there? Awareness moves down into your face, your eyes, your jaw. Is your jaw holding on to any tension that it would like to release? Give your tongue the permission to rest the tip of your tongue just behind your teeth. Drawing awareness down into the throat and in the shoulders. Do the shoulders have any weight that they've been carrying that they would like to release? If so, allow them to let go of the weight of the world. Drawing awareness down into the arms, the wrists and the hands. And for the course of the next few moments, rest your awareness at the tips of all 10 fingers. Moving awareness back up the arms, through the shoulders and into the heart. Rest your awareness in the heart and notice every time you inhale, do your lungs slightly hug your heart? Notice how close your lungs and your heart come to each other. And pause to feel gratitude for this beautiful symbiotic relationship of the heart and the breath, the respiratory and the circulatory systems. Honor those in this moment. Dropping down into the belly, allow it to be soft. You've spent so much time engaging it. Let it to soften. Allow it to let go. And is there any wisdom that it brought to the surface today that it would like to communicate to you? And pause here and listen. Moving down into the hips, the pelvis and the groin, softening and opening. Releasing through the legs. Awareness comes into the knees and the ankles and the feet. And for the course of the next few moments, we rest our awareness in the toes. Moving awareness back up through the legs, the knees, the hips, the glutes. Rest your awareness in the glutes and ask them if they would like to release any more gripping, anything they're holding on to. Feel the earth beneath your glutes. Notice the earth beneath your spine. Notice the earth beneath your back. Notice the earth beneath your heart, the back of your heart, holding the back of your heart, holding the back of your shoulders, holding the back of your arms and the back of your hands, holding the back of your head. Feel the holding of Mother Earth. Feel the space between the back of your neck and the earth. Feel the space above your head. Feel the space above the whole front half of your body. Drawing your awareness to the tips of your nostrils. Is the temperature at the tip of your nostrils different? Are the inhales and the exhales the same or different in temperature? Is your inhale slightly cooler than your exhale? And over the course of the next three breaths, imagine every cell in your body is inhaling, and every cell of your body is exhaling. Bring your hands to your heart center, lying on your mat, and just pause and thank yourself for being here today. Thank yourself for showing up this morning. Thank yourself for taking the time to get logged into this technology and to do this. Thank your body. Thank your effort. Thank all the people in your life who had to come together today to allow this moment in time to happen for you and for each other. Draw more awareness into your breath. Belly raises and belly falls. Begin to wiggle your fingers and toes, bringing aliveness into your body. Reach above your head for a big yawn stretch. Let your body arch. Let your back arch. Good. And then pull your knees into your chest for a big hug. And just let yourself rock side to side, massaging your back into the floor. And then as you feel ready, just fall into the fetal position on one side and just pause for a moment. We as humans, and we especially as Americans, don't spend a lot of time honoring transition. So just pause here for just one resting transition breath. And then come all the way up to seated. Use your top arm to push you up to seated. And bring your hands to your heart center. Friends, I hope you realize today and learn today and had the awareness today that you are more than these muscles. And yet, the more breath, the more aliveness, and the more sensation you bring into these muscles, the more effective they'll be for you. And the more ease and the more grace, more strength, more balance, more flexibility, more power, more support you will have in your life. So let's all take one last deep breath, circle sweeping our arms around and up. As we open up our hearts to infinite possibilities, pull all the goodness in. Pull it all the way down through your heart, into your heart center. Feel your obliques working to do the work. Bow to yourself within. Namaste to yourself deep within your own hearts. The light in me honors the light in you. Thank you for being present. Again, my name is Aubrey Warren, and this is an Effervescent Events production. Thank you for your presence. Namaste.